Hey everyone, I'm out here working on the 335 today. It's a BMW 335. Problem is, let me show you what happens. We start the car, it's been doing this all summer. You don't mind the gas. The 4x4 comes on, and what that means is the front differential is not locking in anymore, and the car, instead of running in all-wheel drive, is now running in only two-wheel drive, which is the rear-wheel drive only. And it's actually been pretty fun to drive all summer. the car is really responsive in two-wheel drive. It's a lot of fun, but as winter's approaching now, I certainly can't have that. I need to fix this, and this is a pretty easy fix. That's another problem I have, is I always need gas. But so let me show you what the problem is. And one thing you'll notice is when you start your car, when it starts to happen, is you hear a grinding noise coming from underneath the I don't know, probably right where the gear shifter is, somewhere right down below there. You hear this grinding noise, and basically the differential is trying to lock in, but it can't. And since it can't, then it just it disables it and just runs in two-wheel drive. So all right, let's get outside and I'll show you what I'm talking about. Okay, well, I'm under the car now, and this right here is the transfer case, and the part that we're going to be changing is right up inside here. So what we're going to have to do is remove these plastic covers all through here. We'll get these out of the way. Okay, so in order to get these plastic pieces out of here, you're going to need an 8mm and a 10mm. The 10mm is for these plastic nuts you're going to see here. So, get this out of the way. Okay, so we need to get this bracket out of the way. It's right here. And there's a 18 right here. It's a bolt, goes all the way through to the other side here. We need to break this loose and get it out. And then there's a bunch of bolts all through this bracket. They're all 13s. So we remove those and then we can get this bracket out of the way. So I'm gonna work on that now. All right, we got the bracket out of the way. Now we can get to our part, which is right here. Okay, so right here is the transfer case actuator motor. This whole assembly here, this is what you're gonna be replacing. And there's a connector we have to disconnect, you can see right here. And then there's also one here. So we're gonna get working on that. We'll get this out of the way. Okay, so in order to get the unit out of here, there's a sensor right here. It sits right here. This is the new one right here. Gotta get this sensor out of the way, and that's an E6 right on the end of it. So you take this out, so you can pull the sensor out. If you don't do that, you're not gonna be able to get this bolt out that's right here. It's right in the way. So in order to get the rest of the bolts out, there's three of them, you're gonna need an E10. An E10 looks like that. All right, let's get on that. All right, we'll just pull it right out. A little bit of oil coming out. Not a big deal. And we'll just disconnect the connector right here. Okay, so for this 335, this is an 08. This is the part I bought. Apparently this happens to almost all the all-wheel drive cars and SUVs as well. So it's the same part, I think, for all of them, same transfer case. So this is the part I bought. Okay, so everything was unplugged. As you can see, I'm gonna plug these back into the new one. We'll plug in the little sensor too, and then we'll put this back up in. Okay, so I got the unit back in place, all three bolts. Plugged in the connectors, put the sensor back on, and screwed it back into place as well. So now I just need to put the bracket back on and everything back together here, and we'll see how this thing works. All right, it was a bit of a bear to get the bolt line back up again here for this bracket, but Once you get things all lined up, it should slide right into place. So we can put this back together, and put these 13s back in to put this bracket back up. All right, well, we got all the covers back in place, and the new unit's in place, so let's give it a try and see if that light goes out now, and see if we go into a four-wheel drive, and hopefully we'll be good for the winter. All right, well, we're all done now. I'm gonna give it a try. I'm gonna start the car. All right, so I guess all four are turning now. And that 4x4 indicator is gone. Now, as you can see, I still need gas, but the 4x4 indication is now gone, and looks like we're back to normal again. All right, guys. Thanks for watching.